Hi, welcome to Digital Principles and System Design. In this video lecture, let's discuss about some of the circuits in the Arithmetic and Logic unit. In the last lecture, we have already seen how to add two bits together, which is the half adder circuit, and then we have extended the addition operation to three bits together, which is the full adder. In this video lecture, let's start with binary adder, which can add two binary numbers, which is n bits long. For binary addition, we require two inputs. One input is A, the other input is B. Both A and B are 4 bits long. We have 4 bits from 0 to 3, and A we call in general as augen and B as adden. Assume that these are the numbers. A is 1011 and B is 0011. When we add A and B together, we get 1 plus 1, which is 10. We get 0 as the sum and carry will be 1. And this carry will be supplied to the next bit and we have to add them together. So A is 1, B is 1 at the bit position 1 and carry is 1. So we get 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is 11. So sum is 1 and carry is 1, which we pass it on to the next bit position. Now we add the carry 1 plus A bit is 0 and B bit is 0. So 1 plus 0 plus 0, which is sum is 1, carry is 0, so we pass on this carry 0 and we get 0 plus 1 plus 0, which is sum is 1 and carry is 0. And notice that the initial carry is also 0. Since we have 3 bits at every bit position that we wanted to add, each of the addition, that is addition of every bit position, we can implement using a full adder, because a full adder is capable of adding 3 bits together. So to implement this binary adder, which is going to add 2 4 bit numbers, we will require 4 full adders so that we can add each individual bit positions independently. But although we can do it independently, the carry of this addition has to be supplied to this bit position. So the input A and B can be supplied to all full adders at once, but the carry will be propagated from this bit position to the next bit position, and which whatever carry we get here in this bit position, we pass it on to the next bit position. That's how we do it manually, right? So we'll implement the binary adder using the full adder circuit. Since we have 4 bits to add, we are using 4 full adder circuit, and to each of the full adder we are passing on the bits of A and B. And the initial carry is 0, C0 is equal to 0, and this full adder will give 2 outputs. One is the sum, which is the final output that we want, 1 bit of the sum, and the carry will be passed on to the next full adder. So this full adder will add C1 plus A1 plus B1, and this will give the sum S1 as output and pass on the carry C to the next full adder. And this full adder will add A2 plus B2 plus C2 and give S2 as the output, and this goes on. Since we have only 4 bits, we have 4 full adders. Suppose if we wanted to add 8 bit numbers, then we will have 8 full adder, and the carry from 4th bit will go on to the 5th bit, and 5th bit carry will go on to the 6th bit, and so on. Now, what is the problem with this circuit? Although this circuit is capable of adding the binary two binary numbers and we can get the result. How much time this circuit will take to obtain the result? That is the question, because the number of full adders will increase as the number of bits that we wanted to add increases. And every full adder is depending on the output of its previous full adder. That means that this full adder depends on this one and this full adder depends on this one. That means that this full adder can give its output only after I get the output of this full adder. And this full adder will depend on this one, and hence this result can be obtained only after obtaining this S0. So when the number of bits increases, the amount of time that the circuit takes will also increase proportionally. Let's see how much time the full adder might take. This is the full adder circuit that we have already seen. And assume uniform delay across all gates. Assume that every gate is taking one unit of time to produce the output after supplying the input. That means that if you supply x, y, z at time t0, I can obtain x XORed with y at time t1 and x, y at time t1, because these two gates are at level 1 and both are having one unit of time delay. So after getting x, y as input, these outputs can be obtained at time t1. So we supply at time t0, we get this output at time 1, and this will be supplied to these gates. Okay, so z, although it is available at time 0, this input is available only at time 1. So we can get the output of this XOR gate and AND gate only at time 2, t2. And what about this one? So this is at level 2. What about this one? This has to depend on the output of this AND gate, and we can get only the output of the OR gate at time t3. So a full adder will take 3 units of time after the input. So we will assume that the full adder is going to take 3 units of time to compute the sum and carry. Let's calculate the delay. So each full adder is going to take 3 units of time to produce the sum and carry. So when we supply A and B at time 0, say for example, this full adder will be able to produce S0 at time unit 3. And this carry will also be available only at time unit 3. And this full adder will operate from time unit 3 and produces here at time unit 6. And this will take 3 more units and produces its output at time unit 9 and so on. So every full adder is going to take 3 units of time. So as the number of bits increases, when we increase the number of full adders, the amount of time that we need to wait to get the output will also increase proportionally. That is, 3 units of time will get increased with every bit that we add with the adder and organ. This is an undesirable property of the circuit, because human beings have very thin patience and we expect the result as soon as we supply the input. So there should be some way to reduce this delay. Let's see how we can do that.